with the crew today.
I said it is the cart.
When you see black men, why we all look?
Who was it?
Crane, you was the only one that looked, baby.
I know, she said, why we all look?
I'm just saying, you know how men see black women and they all break their necks.
We be breaking our necks too when we be seeing black.
That thing fired.
I wish they'd stay on their side of the road, though.
You need to stop looking down.
Y'all, everybody get a chance, because y'all know what I'm really still stuck on, this August Alsina and Jada Pinkett Smith situation. Everybody get a chance. Huh?
Can we get her song?
Yeah. Has everybody gotten a chance to listen to the whole album and look at the lyrics?
No.
You haven't?
Mm-mm.
Girl, I don't normally like give in to all the like celebrity gossip and stuff, but the first time I listened to the album, I read all the lyrics to every song. I said he in love with somebody. So now that this has came out, I'm just like, I feel like it's true. I really feel like it's true. On my shirt, my eyelashes make me look draggish. I'm about to take these mugs off. Hey, dude, cause this one, I don't know what it's doing. This one I actually put on right, y'all. This is my first time putting on eyelashes by myself. This one turned out okay. This one over here looks like I got hit in my eye. It got like an extra bird to it. A bird look to the lash.
If y'all watching, please ignore. Shut up.
How they gonna do that? They supposed to be watching me.
Just ignore what she's saying.
This is gonna be a new extra hot chili and lime. Y'all can't really see. I'm about to see how these taste. But these good, since you like them?
They got real Latina aftertaste to it.
If you didn't know, we are Latina, so I don't know why she's surprised by the taste. No, I'm playing. Mugs be just coming up with stuff. Y'all, I'm trying to tell y'all, this other eye make it look like one of... Make me look lopsided.
Shut up!
It got too much of a lime taste to it for me.
Yeah, it does.
It's just enough spice. Because I like how spicy it is.
I need the spice to be overpowering.
The lime, yeah. They don't know what they're doing. I said, Corinda came out here with her whole house.
I told her not to bring it yet because of the groceries. This is your show. You didn't bring it yet because of the groceries. This is your show. Didn't I say that? I thought you did. It's all right, though.
It's okay. We're going to make the groceries fit. But, so what are we talking about today, y'all? I don't really have no topics ready. I forgot what I had. What's wrong?
Oh, shit, dude. I'm talking about eating this fast.
Don't even be saying
that. Nobody was even worried about that essence. And don't worry about what my best friend doing anyway. No, I'm just playing. I had accidentally said that on the video I was recording yesterday, and I was pissed. I said, hell no. I hate that junk so badly.
And spicy food don't mess with my baby, by the way, so don't say nothing either.
I mean, just the baby gonna like spicy food like her godmommy.
Ask them, for those who were pregnant, what symptoms do they have? Put it in the comments.
Yes.
What
kind of symptoms y'all have, if anybody has children?
I want to know symptoms for boy or girl.
Let's play a guessing game. What y'all think my best friend gonna have? Y'all think my best friend gonna have a boy or girl?
Mainly,
everybody's been saying girl. I said boy. Everybody's been saying a girl.
That whole spicy like Takis, ain't it?
Not that whole spicy like Takis. I said they need to improve these road conditions. I get so sick of these.
So far, it's more people that's team boy than team girl.
You think so, for real?
Because not team boy that think it's gonna be a boy.
Yeah, it's not like we're gonna be happy either way. Yeah. It's just what we predicting some stuff. So
yeah.
Tyra wanted to be a boy.
I was the first person to say it's a girl.
For real?
I wanted to be a girl, but I'm fine with a healthy baby, honestly.
Yes, that's
even if it's a little alien.
Girl, you
messed up.
I'm just playing.
She didn't mean that,
guys. She didn't mean that. Baby, when you get older, you see this video, your mama ain't mean that. Did y'all bring the whole bag out here, or y'all just bring them?
What?
You did just bring them?
Yeah.
Oh.
Damn it. I knew there was something that I was missing.
I said,
get
I got
my
picture.
In my car because y'all told me. You
said they about to get your
I left my Gatorade in there.
Oh, damn.
You said that what?
I forgot that fast.
You said it was about to get your picture.
Yeah, take my picture at the light.
You said what?
Random light.
No, we did it.
I was just playing.
I know. I'm like, no, we did it. Yeah, you got me scared for a second.
She said, you said what? You said what?
I got drip for sale.
Okay, his arm, bitch.
I got drip for sale.
Yeah, his arm.
Oh, you only see one arm?
No, I'm saying on that side of the tattoo. The other one's small.
It is small.
I thought they was feeling a lot off. Hold on.
Yeah. If somebody ever took the time to do that, I'm going
to I can't wait to get some new color.
Y'all, I'm going to do my hair white. It's yellow right now.
We got gray hair color that we still have.
I can't wait to utilize that. My gray hair coloring that I got. Mm-hmm. I just need to order some weave.
It's
going to
be a fire ass.
Somebody want to gift me with some bundles?
Like a bob. Ooh.
Yeah, it's going to be a gray bob.
I need to make my hair
Everybody
white.
Always call me an auntie, so I'm going to just be auntieing out here for real. So, you know, it's so funny because people really do be calling me that, Auntie D. I'm like, why do y'all? So I just went on and accepted the name. You know, I'm going to take
it. She only got a couple of nephews and nieces, okay?
A couple?
I guess Katie's the only one.
I know, I said, what nephew and nieces I got?
Well, Katie's.
We have one nephew right now, and we have one on the way. Hello, Ding. Is that just the baby's just gonna be so much for me? You know, Essence deemed me the god mommy, so that's gonna be my god.
Okay.
I said his bass bumping like that was a fire song, and it's just the weekend. I hate the weekend, bro.
Why do y'all hate the weekend?
You suck. We sound the same on every song.
I like
song.
His music.
I hate the weekend.
Cool. I like some of the songs that he.
I put the weekend, and I know you gonna hate this. I put the weekend in the same category as
Hell
I put
no.
Bryson Tiller.
Hell no.
I hate both of their music. I'm not saying they make the same type of music.
No.
It's just I
no,
can't
no,
listen
no,
to neither
no,
one
no,
of them.
I'm with her with not liking the weekend
because
he sounds like a little child Michael Jackson.
He sounds like a horrible Michael Jackson. Hell,
no,
you can't even put Bryson Tiller in
there. I'm saying them two. I don't like them two for the same reason though.
Weekend is more to the pop.
No, see, you're not saying what I'm saying. I'm saying I only put them in the same category because I don't like them for the same reason. They sound the same. They just like they sound the same on every song to me. No, their music sound completely different. No, I'm not saying that.
Oh, okay.
I'm saying I don't like the both of them because they sound the same to me.
Like yesterday
in the music.
I was like,
girl, heck no, girl. And I hate you already know I hate when people make comparisons to people that ain't even in the same. Whatchamacallit, the same category in genre and stuff like that. I couldn't, hell no.
Hey, real fast. Me and Essie was walking from, me and Essie came walking to the gas station and back home.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, we were thinking like, we hear a boom, like some hood ass song. And we looked over, bro, that's tall. Why these white dudes came, bro? They like the car was low. They was all like the dude was like this.
That happens all the time.
I
right
said,
here. My baby's not playing. I just said it just because we passed it.
We got a meeting on Friday at 3.
Okay, that's fine with me. The places. Sorry for all the bumping and grinding.
No,
my camera is doing.
Daytime.
Wait, it's not in the morning.
My doctor's
appointment. Oh, I was like, wait. And what time is our thing for the? Oh, 3.
I get up at 2:30.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm not going to be able to pick you up from work, so I'm going to be at the doctor's appointment with her.
Bye.
I'll have Kayla pick you up,
man. Yeah, just do that. We can just all just meet up.
And it's up the street, so.
Yeah. That's fine with me. Did y'all see my post? That's what we can talk about. Did y'all see my post on my story where that dude was saying, like, 95% of black women are not wife material?
Yeah.
Are not wife material. He was just like, look at your, you know, media, social media today, how all, you know, all the black women act.
You know how many women, how many black women it is out here in this world?
That's exactly, I'm like, that's a real ignorant ass statement.
Billion and counting people in this world.
That's an ignorant ass statement.
That's very ignorant.
And most of them account for women.
He probably talking about
black women at that. You cannot say 95%.
No, you cannot.
You can say 95% are educated. Come on.
Say
that.
Say facts.
Love it.
State
little
facts.
Baby. State
little
facts. Baby. State
like
facts.
This woman to walk across stage with a diploma.
And so. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. She's about to have her degree. Okay.
And her baby.
Her degree and her baby. Not me, but I was like, that's just an ignorant comment to make, because I'm just like, and it was some people's comment on my story, and they was like, don't you know your social media is only like based off of what you look at all the time? Like your social media shapes around what you be watching. So I'm just like, if you seeing ratchetry on your stuff, you know that's your fault. That's your fault.
You want the ratchetry.
Mm-hmm. And somebody was like, that's self-hate at its finest. I said, on me, because you got a black mama. You're fully black. Even if you wasn't fully black, I still feel like that would be self-hate.
No, but like, what if this man has a daughter? You know, like, how's that going to make her
feel? I hope he would not, because your daughter is automatically going to be black. So, because you're black. At this point, I'm just like, I didn't even get like mad at his statement or anything like that. Because I'm just like, I'm so used to black men making ignorant comments like that about black women nowadays.
We're going to get him on nerves.
And I think it's more publicized now because it's social media. I feel like black men have always had something to say about, not all black men, I'm not saying all of us, all of y'all. I said black men, all of us. I am a dude. But I think it's more publicized now because of social media. Because I feel like, it didn't even make me mad. I just wanted to know what other people thought. Because I'm just like, how could you? You're supposed to be rocking with us. You're supposed to be rocking with us.
Now
you just supposed
like
to
be holding niggas down so much.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
I said, like, dang. I said, you can't see.
I'm sorry.
I feel like oh my god, this baby is so cute. The black women are tossed to the size.
Mm-hmm. Because we already got that name. They that so-called name that they have for us.
Yeah.
We mad.
Angry.
We mad black
angry
women.
Black women.
Mm-hmm. Angry black women. And I was just thinking the other day. I'm like, it amazes me the amount of times that black women, and trust me, I'm a fighter for all black people, all women in general, but just speaking from black women, how many times we have to shut up and keep our opinions to ourselves and our comments and stuff to ourselves so that we aren't seen as angry or bitter or, but anybody else can express their opinions.
Exactly,
and it's just them expressing their opinions. But as soon as we say something, oh, they got an attitude or they angry all the time. I don't be trying to seem angry and bitter, but I'm like, how I talk is how I talk. I can't mask. If you think it's 9 times out of 10, I'm not speaking with an attitude coming from no angry place.
Nope.
It's just how I talk. So I'm just like, and I'm just always having to adjust to everything else. Yeah. I'm like, no, I need people to start adjusting to me.
Right. No, just like when we work in, not even in only corporate America, but just period.
Right.
When we trying to suit our white customers or something, we started to change our voice and tone to sound more like them.
Huh.
So I do it because I feel like, okay, if I'm talking to a white person.
This car was moving at the same time. I thought a mirror was right there. The reflection of the car was going real quick.
Keep going, AC Pop.
I don't know, y'all. Y'all know y'all can't interrupt me while I'm pregnant.
Girl, no, you said changing our voices in corporate America. And you said you even do it sometimes because you feel like,
oh, I feel like my voice to a white person would be nonchalant. Like, I work in sales. So I feel like if I'm like, hi, how you doing? They'll be like, oh, she sound real nonchalant. But I'm like, hi, how are you?
Yeah.
Like, sounding like them. And that's just not even how I talk.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And I think that's something we have to deal with too. Even black men, I feel like, have to do that sometimes too. But I definitely feel like we have to do it. And I find myself, and I hate when I have to change my voice. I hate it because I'm like, that's not how I talk. I'm like, hey girl, how are you? You know, okay, I can get that for it. That's not how I talk. And like, this, how I'm talking right now is how I talk.
And I even be ended up texting her on accident. Like when I'm at work, I'm like, totally, or something. She be cracking.
I'll
like,
be cracking up.
Like, yo, but at work, ain't you?
Oh man, I said mugs. Gotta be around those that's Nordstrom like employees.
Where homeboy kept changing his voice to get like a higher position in that job. I mean, it was a crazy movie, but.
Oh, you talking about
Sorry to Bother You.
Yeah, that movie was. That movie has some hidden messages, for real. Bro, you did with that nigga with them horses at the end, them human and horse hat slash horse movie with that dude. And he worked in that call center.
Yeah, with Donald Glover in there.
Yeah, because I thought Corinne told me that y'all all watched it together at home.
It was me and Mama.
Oh, I thought you said, oh, yeah, see?
I don't remember watching
that, Corinne. Oh, girl, that movie is so, it's weird as heck, but it got some hidden messages in there. The movie is weird as hell, I'm not even going to lie. Amazing.
But yeah, y'all right about that one. I be doing that at work.
When it comes,
because I work at a bank, and so I don't want to, like, you know, be like, hey, how you doing? How many do you want in return? Mm-hmm. You want to change for 20? It's almost like they're like, what?
It's just weird. Like, I don't know. I hate it. I'm working on not having to change who I am around other people. Right. Either y'all gonna adjust to me or y'all not. Me and my mom was just talking about that. She said, either y'all gonna adjust to me or not. I'm sick of having to adjust everywhere I go.
Period, poo.
Not period, poo.
I can't
to calm your demons.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, I'm not.
I'm trying to set up a blaze, okay?
And then it's almost like we have to teach our children, like, it's okay to talk like yourself. Like,
yeah,
you know, you're African American, you are black, and you're beautiful. Yeah, I have to remind Kaden of that.
Even if you talk proper, nothing's wrong with talking proper.
Even if you talk proper, and proper is not basically, hi, yes, I would like, I always do that just to be funny every
proper
time I'm with them.
Enunciating your words.
Exactly. Not like this, you can't do shit.
Nah, but people, wait, that's a whole nother car conversation. People talking to me, you talk proper. I get told all the time because I'm from Kansas. I get told all the time that I talk like a white girl. And I'm just like, from people that's outside of Kansas, though. It's funny. And I'm just like, what does that even mean? I said, I don't talk like no white girl. I'm not white.
How do you talk like a skin color?
Exactly. I used to say that, like, on some ignorant-ish when I was younger. I'm like, oh, they talk white. But as you get older, you can't talk like no skin color. You can't talk like no ethnicity. You can't talk like no race.
You can't talk. You gonna turn it off and I let the window up.
I'm dead, but nah, it's okay because we finna wrap this up so we can go grocery shopping because we are hungry.
That's all like the new position that I work in, because where I work at now with the auto men, they make me feel comfortable. I like
working. Men are amazing.
I like working with people that make me feel comfortable. Men, they love amazing. How black I am too. Like, yes. Even the white ones, they love how
authentic.
Yeah,
I said
they love that about me, and it makes me love that about me. Not that I need any validation or nothing, but that's something that you haven't. No, I don't really know that people experience that in the workplace.
Yeah, because it can be challenging at times.
If I would work if I was able to work with men, that would be great. Like, with black men, because sometimes they need a woman's perspective on things, because they'll go the whole different route or expensive. No, I'm saying they look for expensive things. We look for discounted things. Like, we could get this much for.
Yeah, they be looking at the first thing they see.
We more practical, think stuff through. It's okay because men and women balance each other out. Mm-hmm. Women, that we need them and they need us, but they try to act like. They don't need us, okay?
It goes both ways. I don't even Jeff like that. Look at all these independent black womans out here. I don't need no man.
I was just about to say that.
I mean, it do go both ways. Everything I say be going both ways, to be honest.
But we talking about what's more practical in the society. Yes, it always goes both ways. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, because we probably gonna go on and get up out of here because we
like
done cut the
car.
I
feel sophisticated.
I'm sorry, I'll unlock it.
I was gonna say, you feel sophisticated?
Come out the door.
I
can't. It doesn't look right here.
Yeah, I don't think that one worked. I don't know.
Charlotte.
But thank y'all for tuning in to another car conversation. We finna go in here and go grocery shop because we are hungry. But thank y'all for tuning in, and we gonna come back to y'all with another video in a few days. All right, deuces.
Maybe that's the reason why I love you.